Hey everyone, this is the brief feature showcase of the Nisarga addon. The scene you just saw was made using the assets from the Nisarga addon and the landscape generated using the A.N.T landscape addon. Currently, we are running a summer sale on davoxel.com. If you are interested in purchasing the addon, it's the right time for you, as you can get it right now at 25% off using the coupon code SUMMERSALE22. The link is in description. Previews are loaded extremely fast. No matter how slow your PC is, you can smoothly navigate through the library, and even the assets load pretty fast. We have also provided the buttons that make navigation more convenient. You can skip directly to the end of library or to the beginning of the library with a single click. Another useful feature of the Nisarga addon is the snap to ground button. With this, you can snap the assets directly to the surface below it within a single click. You can also easily tweak Nisarga assets and their materials and textures with the make editable checkbox or button. With the new update, you can directly alter the leaf's brightness from the Nisarga panel using the leaf brightness slider. And as soon as you press the update button, the leaves got updated immediately. Nisarga comes with the feature-rich geometry nodes based scatter system, which consists of awesome features like viewport display optimizations, wind animation for grass, and masks. There are various types of masks. First one is height mask. Using this mask, distribute the vegetation across the terrain based on the elevation of the terrain. Next is slope mask, using which we can distribute the vegetation depending on the slope of the terrain. Another one of the coolest masks is the camera cooling mask, which distributes the vegetation only in the camera's visibility area, and it is the most useful addition to the viewport performance. The next one is the distance cooling mask, and this is also a very important addition to viewport performance, as you can decide the density of the vegetation based on the distance from a certain object. Like, we can set the distance from the camera and it will distribute more near the camera and less in the far areas from the camera. The curve proximity mask is also one of the coolest masks, as you can draw the curves on the terrain and the vegetation will grow depending on the distance from the curve. And similar to this is a mesh proximity mask. This one grows the vegetation depending on the distance from the mesh object. And last in the mask is the vertex paint mask. And using this, you can wet paint and define a certain area as a mask to grow the vegetation on. Wind animation. This feature is currently only available for grasses, and soon we will be bringing the wind animation for the trees and plants. You can also enable proxy for optimal viewport performance. And there are tons of more such features. You can try the trial version for free only on davoxel. And if you want a tutorial for this scene or the blend files, comment down below and the next video will be on it. Thanks for watching. See you soon.